next flower I want to show you is the amaryllis. It's a bulb, and each year, you know, I grow one, and so it will bloom around Christmas time, start it maybe 6 to 8 weeks early. So you have those beautiful blooms, and they come in such spectacular colors. I'm going to do a little bit of a variety here, but, you know, the usual one that you see is the beautiful red one that makes its entrance and really is a stunner. You know, the typical amaryllis has three flowers on each stem. Let's start by talking about the stem. I'm going to, I've cut two here, one out of green cardstock and one out of white. And I'm going to put a little bit of glue on the green one just so it'll hold together. This way, I not only give stability to those three big blooms that are at the top, but it gives you a little bit of dimension as well. If you take your tweezers and just line it up. Now, this one does have a bloom on it, and I'll show you how I treat that. But we're going to just color the stem. Usually, the stem is a brighter green than the leaves. I'm going to go right up on this side here. And I don't have to color the back of this because I use the green cardstock. But I am going to do a little bit of shading on this. Since this does have some red in it, I want to add just a little touch of red. See. We'll put a little bit of red at the base here, and then I'm going to blend it in. You'll see this coloration in the stem when you see your blooms. Now, as far as the bloom goes, I'm just going to take a marker. This is an alcohol marker, and color it in the color of my blooms that I'm putting on this. Now, the only thing, other thing I'm going to do, I'm going to turn it over on this side, and with the loop tool, I'm going to press on that bloom to make it more dimensionalized, so you'll see it kind of curve, and you can even pinch it a little bit here to wrap around, so you get a little bit of dimension on that. I'm going to bring in a card here, and we'll add some glue. These are really pretty on those elongated cards that are so popular now. Grab a toothpick. And I'm just going to paint some. I'm actually going to run this glue all the way up because, like I said, with the three blooms, you want to make sure it holds well. I'm not putting any on that bloom that I dimensionalized, though. I'm going to set it right in here because I've got still space to put my quote at the end. And let's set this aside and talk about the flowers. The first thing I'm going to do is add a little bit of green to the center. Because this one has, that I'm doing here, is going to have some white in it. It's going to be variegated as such. Now, normally I color from the inside out. This one I want to leave a little bit of a stripe down the middle of white. And so I'm adding it just on the sides here, kind of brushing the color in. Now, you can do this easily with a dauber too and your distressed inks. You don't have to use the alcohol. I just prefer the alcohol. And then I'm going to color on the back side the same way, although I didn't add any green because you won't see that when it's placed down. Now, I'm not being too careful with this. I'm just not going over that center too much because I don't want to discolor that white on the other side and chance that the ink will bleed through. There's so many varieties, whites, a chartreuse, peach. I mean, you can just, you know, have a field day with these beautiful amaryllis. And we all, you know, a lot of times you'll give these as gifts. You know, you might wrap up a bulb in a beautiful pot to give someone as a gift so it'll bloom for them. It's nice to have something blooming in the wintertime. And this really hits the mark with that because the colors are just stunning and they do last quite a long time. Like the poinsettia, it's become very recognizable for the holiday. Now this one has a stamen that's a little bit light pale green, but it'll vary. Like the red one that I showed you earlier has a very dark red stamen. So it'll just depend on the variety that you choose. On your stamen, you do need to cut the filaments, and I'm going to cut them all down. You'll see they're elongated. Some are longer than others. And then if you take your tweezer, bring this glue over here again, and right along that end, all you want to do is paint it with some glue. Twist it around and take it off. Get glue on my finger here, but I kind of roll it in my hands. And then I'm going to bring in some darker pollen here and just lightly tip the ends with a little bit of glue and into the pollen. And we can set that aside. Now that the red ink has dried a little bit, I'm going back with a white marker, and you can get these white markers anywhere. This is an acrylic marker that has the white, and I'm really going over that center again so you get that white striping, plus a little bit of feathering out from each side, because I know this variety has that characteristic. And sometimes my coloring gets off a little bit, so I can add that white right back in. And I'm going to do that on both these pieces. Like I said, this is just one of my favorites. But you can, if you prefer the dark red, beautiful pinks, not only in soft, but in very hot pink shade. Now all you have to do is shape it. So using your small loop tool, I'm just going to stroke coming down from the outside towards the inside on all the petals, both pieces. I'm going to shape that in a second, but I'm going to do that on this one as well. This is your three little inner petals. If you want to make this into a double, just cut two of these inner petals and you can make a double amaryllis. Now you're going to need your reverse tweezers. I'm going to pinch here, and then I'm going to take, while I'm holding that pinch with my opposite index finger and thumb, I'm going to pinch the end a little bit to come to a point. I'm rolling these edges just to make them look a little bit more natural. Glue on there. I'm going to do that same thing on here. The only thing is I'm not rolling, I'm just pinching that outer and bringing it down. Then you want to use your small ball stylus and cup each one of these in the middle. and then you can see where the two petals come together. You want to line that up with the single one there, so you've got offsetting. Isn't that pretty? So I like to put mine in some kind of molding dish. This is just an old candy dish that I used. I'm going to hold it down in there. It helps hold the bloom together while it's drying, and you get a nice upright bloom. And then I'm just dipping my stamen into the glue, and it goes right in the center. Again, I'm going to press down a bit while I'm holding that there. I'm going to set these aside a second, and we'll talk about the leaves. The leaves are really elongated. So you want to take your leaf tool on your leaf mat here, and I'm going to place this right side down and run a line down the center, almost like a stem line. And then I'm going to pinch up on it. Now the leaves also have some light and dark areas to it. So if you like, you can always take your pan pastels and add some of that bright green into it just to highlight those areas, because it does stay nice that way. And see, I've done that on these here. Now it's just a matter of putting them together. So make sure you have some glue. And here's the ones I've done earlier. I like to put two on either side. Like I said, I'm going to hold it down there a second till it grabs. That glue grabs pretty quickly. But if you don't have the kid's choice, you can always use, one that holds up. I usually say test it by making sure it'll create a peak. See, by letting it dry a little bit in a mold, they just stand up so nicely. Let me make sure I've got enough glue on that one. And I'm going to set it right in there. Hold it down a bit so it grabs. And then all we have to do is add our leaves. Now, I know some glue is going to show for a little bit on these leaves, but also make sure you choose. Make sure that one curves down a bit so it doesn't. Whoops. There we go. Don't want it to hit my bloom. And for decorative purposes, if you like, you can add a little bit of, I use some hot glue at the base here. Oops, didn't mean to get it over there, but. And then you can put some Spanish moss out, because usually when you find the bulbs and put them in a beautiful decorative pot, they have the Spanish moss around them to keep them nice. Now all we have to do is peel off our quote here. I'm going to add a little glue onto my foam tabs because that'll help hold it longer. And there are many gifts under the Christmas tree, but the best one is the gift of your friendship. There you go. That's the Amaryllis. I hope you enjoy it, and happy holidays.